But we are known overseas for comedy. We really are. We have got guys who are world famous for comedy. And so, what we have is a visitor to our fair country who is originally from India, who now lives in the Netherlands and is a comedian there. And he has just happened to be in South Africa and he came straight to Parker's and he said, can you do some comedy for us? And I said, fuck, I don't know, I'll ask the audience, what do you think? Yeah. And so, ladies and gentlemen, please give a huge, warm, fantastic South African welcome to your bonus act for this evening for a short set. Please welcome on stage, Sandeep Matthew.
Just arrived in South Africa. Thank you. That was good music as well. So yeah, I just arrived here 7 days back, and I know there have been Indians here for 5-6 generations. And the reason they've been here is because the Britishers felt they were, you know, some of us are strong enough to do physical labor here. The rest of us small puny guys like me just got converted to Christianity. And I now live in the Netherlands. I moved there about 3 years back on work. I stayed there with my wife. And so when I was coming here to South Africa, people were telling me things like, you know, be really careful there. Don't venture out at night. Don't speak to strangers. Don't just, you know, have any food from the streets. And I was just thinking to myself, wow, I'm going home. Yeah, in the last 1 week over here, I actually realized that a lot of things similar between India and South Africa. You know, for example, we have load shedding there. We have load shedding here. We love our cows there. We love cows here. Except that here's on the plate. But the good thing is, I'm quite blended over here, you know, and thankfully there are none of these stereotypes, because everywhere else I go, people just immediately look at me and think I'm from India, and then there are all these stereotypes attached to that. For example, Trevor Noah himself did this once. He said how Indians can never play the bad guy in a Hollywood movie. And that's completely true, you know, just imagine the big screen coming up and the bad guy who shows up there is about to give his terrorizing message is an Indian. The first thing he would actually say is this on? So we're pretty bad at that. Let me just recollect before I forget. Yeah, so there are lots of these stereotypes. Some of the stereotypes are true, but some are definitely not. You know, for example, people just see the amount of population back in India, and they think everyone over there just loves making babies, and they automatically think I have kids as well. And the thing is, I don't have kids. I mean, I really like babies, but as long as they're somebody else's. And the reason why I don't, you know, want to have kids is because I've not heard a single person talk about being happy about having kids. I mean, they all love having their kids, but they just hate parenting. And it's not just when they have toddlers, you know, even when the kid gets a little older, say 6 or 7 years old, they would still be pretty annoying, you know, because by then they've figured how to use your phone, and then they completely messed up your YouTube algorithm. Because the other day I was with a friend and we were watching this really interesting TED talk about, you know, farm animals, and suddenly switches to a video of my puppy. And then people say, you know, once a kid gets a little older, say 17 or 18, they would finally leave the house. But then that's not true for us Indians. We never leave the house. And even if we do, I have a couple of young cousins who are in that age group of 17, 18 who've just gone out. They would still be very annoying, you know, because they would call up their parents and ask the most stupidest of things. Things like, you know, how much water do I need for boiling my rice? So you know, parenting can be pretty annoying. And parenting is a job that never ends, right? And then life expectancy is only increasing. So say you have a kid at the age of 30 and then you go on to live to the age of 100. That's 70 years of parenting. Pretty scary problem. So yeah, that's one stereotype, you know, that's probably not true, but yeah, there are others that are true. Like, for example, how Indians can never say no. I mean, for me, it's quite unnatural for me to shake my head this way and say no. Because if you were to ask me anything, my natural reaction, default reaction, is to just go like this. and just say, yeah, okay. You know, it's like, yeah, and the hands. Yeah, it's like, you know, we agree to everything, sort of like Prince Harry. Just imagine Meghan going and telling him, I know you're a prince and all that, but you need to quit this job. And then Harry goes, yeah, okay. And I'm pretty sure that's how we got converted to Christianity as well. You know, Britishers, all those generations back, came up to us and just said, is your one true God, Lord Jesus? And then we went, yeah, okay. And that can be pretty dangerous, you know, sometimes, because there's this one time I was with my wife, we went for a wedding. And they were serving alcohol there. And I just asked her, and I was like, would you mind not drinking so that you can drive back? And she goes, yeah, okay. So then I get completely drunk over there. And then when I get into the car, I'm seeing everything blurred in front of me. And I'm just so glad I'm not driving. And that's when she tells me, she's like, why is everything so blurred? And I was like, 1 second, you didn't drink, right? And then she's like, oh yeah, I forgot my glasses. But yeah, her default reaction was just to say, yeah, okay, immediately, you know. So yeah, so there are these couple of stereotypes. And the thing is, you know, this way you should never ask an Indian for directions. Because most of them, you know, a lot of times they wouldn't even know where to go, but they will still insist on giving you directions. Just because they can't say no. And the way they would give you directions also is pretty confusing, you know. For example, one time I asked this guy, and this is what he told me. He's like, go straight, there's a left, don't take that left. Go some more straight, there's a right, don't take that right. Go some more straight, there's a left, take that left, there's a hill, go over the hill, come down, and on the right is your address. And by this time you've completely lost him, right? And then depending on where you're from India, sometimes you don't speak the same language, they will still insist on telling you directions. You know, so it would go something like this. It would be like, go, 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 go. Yeah, so never ask Indians for directions. And actually realize in the last one week over here, it's pretty entertaining here as well, you know, because here you use robots. You say, as a robot take a left, at the next robot take a right. And me being a software engineer, the first time I heard this, I was so excited. I actually thought there's a real robot over there showing directions. So yeah, that's how it's been for me over here. And thankfully, I've been blending in over here and I've not been facing those stereotypes. And in fact, on the contrary, I've been really enjoying it, because the other day I was with a couple of colleagues and we ordered in some food. And the moment the food came in, one of my colleagues who speaks Afrikaans just looks at the food and goes, lekker. And I was like, wow, this is exactly what we say back in Netherlands, you know. So for a moment, I actually felt I was home. So yeah, it's been really great over here. Thank you so much for being so warm and friendly, and I've completely been enjoying my time over here. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sandeep Madhur!